Today we'll be learning about how brain develops from the embryonic stage till the time it goes to into the mature form. So initially in the embryonic stage, brain is nothing but a form in the form of a neural tube. Okay, so brain is just a neural tube. It is not as complex as it looks like as a fully grown brain in case of a young adult or a human. But initially in the embryonic stage, it is in the neural form. Later on, it starts to grow and it starts to develop. Here again, inside the embryo, the neural tube now grows into three divisions, which are called as the three vesicles of the brain, which are preferably called as presencephalon. Okay, the second one is called as mesencephalon, and the third one is called as rhombencephalon. Right, so these are the three structure or vesicles which are developed from the neural stage. So the neural tube is developed into presencephalon, mesencephalon and rhombencephalon. In the terms of HAP or pathology or physiology, we call this process as differentiation process, because something which is a cellular mass grows into something which is very distinguished. Okay, and later on this structure grows into what we call as forebrain, midbrain and hindbrain. So here I like to highlight that presencephalon grows and develops into the forebrain, the mesencephalon grows and develops into the midbrain, and the rhombencephalon grows and develops into the hindbrain. Fine. So what happens at the 5th week of the embryo? After 5 weeks of the embryo, after the embryo is 5 weeks old, now the brain again further starts to grow and develop, and the presencephalon, this further classifies or differentiates into something called as diencephalon, which we learn in the complex human brain structures. So this is further dividing into telencephalon and diencephalon. So this presencephalon, after the 5 weeks of embryonic stage, it differentiates into two parts. So this structure is dividing into two parts, so differentiating into two parts. One part is called as diencephalon, the other part is called as telencephalon. We all know that diencephalon is comprising of thalamus and the hypothalamus, right? And we also know that telencephalon is something which grows into or which is called as the cerebrum. Okay. So let's again come back to the different structures we are learning about. Presencephalon is diversifying or differentiating into diencephalon and telencephalon, whereas the rhombencephalon, this rhombencephalon, I'm just writing rhombencephalon, we all know the full meaning. The rhombencephalon is further dividing or is further classifying itself into metencephalon and the myelencephalon. Right? Okay. So now, whenever we talk about a fully grown human brain, we talk about three things, that is rhombencephalon, presencephalon, and as well as the mesencephalon. So mesencephalon stays the same. It is not further divided. Now it remains undivided. This structure after 5 weeks remains undivided. It is still called as the midbrain. The presencephalon or the forebrain is divided into diencephalon and the telencephalon, which further divides into thalamus, hypothalamus and cerebrum. And the rhombencephalon is further classified into metencephalon and myelencephalon, right?